Hi, Father, I just thank you for this time again. And oh, Lord, I thank you for this wonderful, whether it was in the body, out of the body, as Paul said, I don't know. If it was a dream or vision, I really honestly don't know this time. I just know that it happened, okay? And it was glorious and it was wonderful. And you know, I'm going to share it. And I wrote it down. Of course, I got it in my book here. I got it written down. Because I'm learning that the Lord wants me to stay on track. And I can get off track, as you all know me, that are watching my show. Whether it's one or two or three or ten or a thousand, it doesn't matter. God's in control, not me. I don't even worry about it. Oh, my goodness. I used to, when they told me I had to have 1,000 people to be live, I used to wanted to do that because when I'm out, I just like to share, you know, what's going on. But the Lord said, Sharon, it's fine. You don't have to do it live. And, you know, it is, because I've done most of my shows live, you know. I mean, even the old shows on television, and I knew how to edit and everything, but they keep changing everything, so I didn't know how to do it, because the other way it was easier, and the technology, of course, I don't really think they want us to do anything, because they want us to be robots, and obey them, and do what they say, you know, the big tech guys, and all them big corporations. But you know what, God is greater than all them, and I'm not worrying about them, you know, and you don't either, and you don't have to fear, you don't have to do any of that. Have that peace and joy and rest inside that only Jesus can give us. He can only give it to me and you both. So let's just let him be God and be our Lord and our King and our Shepherd, and let the Holy Spirit lead us. He's the one that anoints us, gives us the power to do things. We can do nothing on ourselves. We need the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I'm telling you. Oh, the Holy Spirit. Oh, my goodness, Yeshua, Messiah, Jesus Christ, you know, we need them, we do. And I only use those because I know that the Jewish people, that's who he was called. He was called Yeshua, Messiah, in the Jewish, because he is Jewish people. I don't think it matters, really, but, you know, he is Jewish, you know, and he's our Lord if we let him be, that's all. Master owner. Okay, I'm going to get back to my... Okay. This just happened on Wednesday the 16th. And now, you know, of course, I've shared the three baptisms. I had the happy Valentine's Day. And then I came back and made a correction because I realized it was missing the N. And then, right now, this is... On Wednesday, this is what the Lord gave me, and I still know it's for today, which is, today is the 18th, so it's 2 days ago. Anyway, no time to waste. Oh my goodness, we really don't have any time to waste, guys, and girls, and boys. You know, we really don't, you know. Watch and pray. That's what God is saying to us strongly as his children. Watch and pray. His word, again... There's his word, again, telling us to watch and pray, you know, so we need to do that in the Holy Ghost. And you know why I say that? Because the Holy Ghost speaks mysteries and knows what we need. He knows what others need. So when you speak in tongues, I'm telling you, and yes, we can understand what we're saying. I only know this much, really, and I've been saved for 36 years. And yet I think it's a lot sometime, but, you know, really, it's only that much. There is so much in here. None of us have it all, okay? And if you think you do, get on your face because you're getting prideful. You know, my pastor taught me, even him, and he taught me a lot more than you've taught me. No matter who you are out there, he taught me a lot, but he always told me this. I still only know this much. It's because as we grow, God gives us more and trusts us more. We hear more because we're getting closer to Him. We're having that fellowship with Him. We're getting to know Him. It was just so bright. An alarm was sounding. And God and Jesus were letting me know it's time to do His will as it is in heaven. Oh my goodness, is all I could say, and speaking in tongues. Then I turned and saw, okay, first you gotta realize, God was there. He was so bright. I mean, the brightest bright, pure, holy, oh my goodness, love. He was and He is. Oh, He was just there, and He was so bright. And then Jesus was here. Oh, my goodness, and I mean, His love and everything was there, too. And then, all of a sudden, it was like I was looking over this way, and there was my Pastor Bill, my senior Pastor Bill. He's gone to heaven. Oh, and He was there, and He was so bright and shiny. He really was. Oh, my goodness. He was so bright and shiny. And He came and He just put His arms all around me like Jesus did in 1995. I told you about that. And you know what? I'll go back because I'm getting off track, I know. Okay. Oh, my goodness, is all I could say, and speaking in tongues. Then I turned and saw our Pastor Bill, oh, wearing a long sleeve shirt and a vest over the shirt, over it. He was bright, very bright. And He came, and I went toward Him, and He gave me such a big hug, like never before. He never gave me a hug like that when on the earth, you know, when I was at the church and He was at the church. I never got a hug like that. That's because it was God's love. Oh, and it was pure love, pure love. Oh, my goodness. Oh, my goodness. I didn't even read that, but that's what it says here. I was so overwhelmed. I really was. I got very emotional and distraught, probably, you know. But I was just so overwhelmed by it, by all of it. I woke up crying for all. I mean, I was speaking in tongues and crying, and oh, I was so emotional because people are going to hell. People are lost, and they don't even know it, you know. Oh, crying for all and speaking in tongues. We have to do our Father's will as it is in heaven. Souls are lost, even some of us sleeping. All the while, Jesus is coming. I am coming, He said to me. And my honey, Bill, when I woke up, he was, you know, well, when I got up, my honey was praying for me in tongues, too. And you know what? Whether it was a vision, a dream, or I was in the body or out of the body, I don't know. And that's what came to me after I realized, I don't know. I really don't with this one. I don't know if I was in the body, out of the body, a dream, a vision. All I can tell you is Jesus is close. He's so close, people. We got to be ready. Oh, we don't want nobody to be lost, so we got to tell them. We got to tell them, don't stop speaking. We got to tell them our Lord is coming. He is coming, and they will be left behind if they aren't ready. We got to have a relationship with our Lord, a relationship. He's the way, the truth, and the life. Come and go. Get in the boat. Don't be out of the boat. Get in the boat. Get in Jesus. Be with Jesus. Oh, come and go. He loves you so. He really does. And he says, Sharon, keeps telling me, feed my sheep. Go fish. You know? Go fish. Oh, my goodness. And I'm going to share a testimony about that, too. And we're going to name it, Shut Up. Go fish, because that's exactly how it was. Anyway, I love you all, and he loves you, oh my goodness, so much more, all around. He loves you all around. I love you this much, okay? Oh my goodness, but it's, oh my goodness, it's enough, more than enough right now. Oh my goodness, oh my goodness. It's getting close, people, so close. Be ready. I love you. Shalom.